اللهم اجعلنا مستحقين نقول بشكر. أبانا الذي في السماوات، تقدس اسمك، يأتي ملكوت، تكن مشيئتك كما في السماء كذلك على الأرض. خبزنا الذي لا يضع أعطينا اليوم، واغفر لنا ذنوبنا كما نغفر نحن أيضا المذنبين إلينا، لا تدخلنا في تجربة لكن نجينا من الشرير. المسيح يسوع ربنا، لأن لك الملك والقوة والمجد. Okay, so today, because we're late, instead of having 10 or 15 minutes English and then Arabic, let's do a mix for 15 minutes. And I think most of us here understand both, so quite, yeah. طيب كل سنة وطيبين. احنا لسه في أيام الباراكليت, the Holy Spirit. Yesterday, Sunday was... the gospel was a was about a was about the parable of the min, friend of midnight, مش كده؟ صديق نصف الليل. وفي آخر المثل, المسيح يسأل السؤال ده, بيقول إيه بالإنجليش؟ بيقول if a son asks for bread from any father among you, will he give him a stone? Or if he asks for a fish, will he give him a serpent instead of a fish? بيقول من منكم وهو أب يسأله ابنه خبزا يعطيه فيعطيه حجرا, أو سمكة يطلب منه سمكة فيعطيه حية بدل السمكة؟ في أب يعمل كده؟ Or if he asks for an egg, will he offer him a scorpion؟ إذا سأله بيضة فيعطيه عقربا؟ If you then being evil know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will your heavenly father give the Holy Spirit to those who ask him؟ فإن كنتم وأنتم أشرار تعرفون أن تعطوا أولادكم عطايا جيدة, وأنتوا أشرار تعرفوا الأب يعرف يدي ابنه حاجة كويسة, فكم بالحري الآب الذي من السماء يعطي إيه؟ مش يعطي إيه؟ يعطي الروح القدس للذين يسألونه. This is the big gift, And then Abuna Aaron was talking to us yesterday about this, and he was saying what? He was saying why we do not ask for the Holy Spirit. And he offered one reason, strong one actually. He says that we sometimes do not feel the need. We do not feel the need of, if we really feel إن إحنا محتاجين, if we really feel إن لما ربنا يشوفني أنا فعلا محتاج, هيديني. فهنا في وعد في الآية دي من ربنا إن he is ready to give the Holy Spirit. هو مستعد يدي الروح القدس للذين يسألونه, بس يسألونه. المثل ده كله الـ goal behind it إن there is no way God as a father would not give the need to his children, which is the Holy Spirit. فأنا I was thinking تاني why we do not need, أبونا الأول when we ask it أول first, why we do not ask for the Holy Spirit. I came up with two simple reasons. Sorry, مش عارف مكتوبة غلط. Number one, إن هي because we do not believe, مش مصدقين إن ربنا هيدينا روح القدس. فده المثل ال parable ده deals with it. God is promising and whoever asks is gonna have, and he gave the example of the friend that came during midnight and he says there is no way his friend would not open for him and give him. Same with God. Number two, the point of what Abuna Aaron was discussing, in that we do not feel the need for the Holy Spirit. I added that we do not feel that thirsty. احنا كنا عارفين the verse that Christ said in whoever thirst let him come to me and drink, and he was talking about the water of the Holy Spirit. This is what St. John said. So if the person does not feel that he's thirsty, he would not come, he would not ask for the water. ف why ليه احنا مش حاسين ان احنا عطشانين او ان احنا محتاجين الروح القدس؟ maybe احنا مش عارفين ايه غالبا السبب ان احنا مش عارفين ايه الروح القدس ده, احنا قد ايه محتاجينه واحنا مش متخيلين. احنا we do not understand how much we need it and what would it do to us. So I thought okay, let's try to see the Holy Spirit has lots of a lot of work in us, but let's take one simple point. Maybe this will steer our hearts up to to send up and ask for the Holy Spirit. So before we jump into this, I just want to make sure that we understand the difference between the gifts of the Spirit and the fruits of the Spirit. اللي هي مواهب الروح القدس وثمار الروح القدس. The gifts of the Spirit are gifts that the Spirit gives to members of the church to fulfill his purpose. And the main difference is that we should not want, يعني one should not ask for specific gifts of the Holy Spirit. مش مفروض ان الواحد مننا يطلب موهبة من مواهب الروح القدس. هي الروح القدس يديله زي ما هو يحب. هو عارف كل واحد فينا احتماله ايه وقلبه ايه. ما مش مفروض ان الانسان يبقى نفسه في المواهب بشكل خاص. However, the fruits of the Spirit, ثمار الروح القدس. Every one of us should seek and ask for the fruits of the Spirit. And actually, يعني God is ask is waiting on us to bring forth a to يعني bring forth fruit the fruits of the Spirit. وكلنا عارفين ثمار الروح إن مواهب الروح اللي هي مثلا زي speaking in tongues, زي مثلا the gift of مثلا casting out demons, the gift of there are simple gifts, simpler gifts. يعني مثلا في the gift of let's say wisdom, spiritual fatherhood, الأبوة الروحية. مواهب كتير روح القدس يديه للكنيسة يعني عموما. إنما ثمار الروح القدس مطلوبة من كل واحد, اللي هي محبة, فرح, سلام, طول أنا. طيب فتعالوا نبص على ثمار الروح القدس اللي هو بيديها لنا لما يحل فينا. فيقوم يعني نشتاق قلبنا ان احنا نحس ان احنا محتاجين جدا للحاجات دي فنقف نطلب. ف يعني let's start كده by reading a quote by St. Anthony and we can discuss مثلا he discussed some of the يعني what the Holy Spirit does in us. في الأول كده he says what he says, this great fiery spirit that whom I have received, you as well receive him. If you wish to receive him and that he dwells in you, offer first the labor of the flesh and the humility of the heart, and lift up your thoughts to heaven night and day, and ask with an upright heart for this fiery spirit, ask for, with an upright heart for this fiery spirit, and he shall be given to you. بالعرب بيقول ذلك الروح النار العظيم الذي قبلته أنا, ده أما أنطونيوس اللي بيكلم, الذي قبلته أنا, اقبلوه أنتم أيضا, وإذا أردتم أن تقبلوه ويسكن فيكم, قدموا أولا أتعاب الجسد وتواضع القلب, وارفعوا أفكاركم إلى السماء في الليل والنهار. ده واحد مشتاق جدا يعني وانا feels the need day and night يعني asking for it. واطلبوا باستقامة قلب هذا الروح الناري وحينئذ يعطى لكم. For sure كده ده San Anthony saying from experience, if you ask this way you're gonna يعني get this gift. وكده بيقول إيه, what happens about when you get the spirit, he said, and when you shall receive him he will uncover to you the mysteries of the highest and other things I cannot express. And heavenly joy shall be unto you night and day. And you shall be in this body as if in the kingdom. And you shall ask no more for yourselves only, but for others as well. For he who receives the Spirit is able to ask for others. العرب بيقول إيه؟ بيقول إذا قبلتموه أيوة. فإنه يكشف لكم الأسرار العلوية, أسرار السماء. وأمورا أخرى لا أستطيع أن أعبر عنها, أسرار بقى ما يقدرش يحكيها لكن روحه يكشفها له. ويكون لكم فرح سماوي ليلا ونهارا, فرح سماوي ليلا ونهارا لما الروح القدس يحل في الإنسان. وتكونون في هذا الجسد كمن هو في الملكوت, كأن الإنسان طاير كأنه ما بقاش يعني على الأرض. ولا تعودون تطلبون عن أنفسكم فقط, ده لما الروح يحل, لا تعودون تطلبون عن أنفسكم فقط بل عن الآخرين أيضا, لأن كل من قبل هذا الروح يستطيع أن يطلب عن الغير. فأنا النهاردة نفسي نركز على موهبة صغيرة يعني مش يعني موهبة كبيرة للروح القدس, هي موهبة الفرح, joy. سوري يعني ثمرة مش موهبة, the fruit of joy. We all know يعني that in the gospel يعني the Bible always يعني links between the Holy Spirit and joy. Many verses in the Bible, I just brought here three examples يعني. يعني احنا عارفين انه when St. Paul tried to يعني number كده the fruits of the Spirit, he gave 9 fruits. Number 1 when he said what the fruit of the Spirit is, love, number 1, and number 2 was joy and peace. Love, joy and peace. أما ثمر الروح فهو محبة, فرح, سلام. احنا we are missing بصراحة this fruit a lot in our lives sometimes, the fruit of joy. If the Holy Spirit is يعني lives in us, لو روح القدس عايش فينا, المفروض نبقى عايشين في فرح سماوي ومفيش حاجة تضايقنا, مفيش حاجة, مفيش هم. فإذا لو الإنسان حاسس إنه ما عندوش الفرح وفقد الفرح, يبقى حل إيه؟ يبقى حل إنه يقف يطلب الروح وفرح الروح. Second verse بيقول and the in the book of Acts when the church was growing in the beginning خالص, He says, and the disciples were filled with joy and with the Holy Spirit. You can see that there is correlation here. When they get filled with the Holy Spirit, they get filled with إيه؟ With joy. أما التلاميذ فكانوا يمتلئون من الفرح والروح القدس. Another verse بيقول St. Paul to the Romans بيقول, for the kingdom of God is not eating and drinking, but righteousness and peace and joy in the Holy Spirit. ملكوت الله ليس أكلا وشربا بل هو بر وسلام وفرح في الروح القدس. هو ده ملكوت الله. يعني we don't need to wait until we go to heaven to live the kingdom of God. If we have the joy of the Holy Spirit, then we are in, this is the kingdom of God. ففرح الروح. فرح الروح ده حاجة كده يعني زي ما هنشوف كده is very different from يعني anything we, in this in the world and يعني it makes the person live in a different way. Let's see some differences. يعني أنا I try كده to put some points on the difference between the joy of the spirit and the joy of the world. It's very different. There are يعني the joy of the world we all know it. The joy that I got a good grade. The joy that someone I know had, مثلا something good happened to him. Someone got married. All the joys of the world we know. However, when Christ was with his disciple and was talking about the Spirit in the gospel that we read in the third hour, he said, not as the world gives you, do I give you. ليس كما يعطي العالم أعطيكم. العطية بتاعتي is different. إيه اللي different؟ تعالوا نحاول نجت ديب عشان نفهم يعني هو مش ممكن نفهم هي. It's not something to be expressed, it's something to be experienced. طبعا, the joy of the Spirit. بس تعالوا نشوف. The main problem of the world, of the joy of the world, and how it's very short-lived, very temporary. يعني imagine مثلا that you hear a very good news today, and you're so happy, and then right a second, the next minute you hear a very bad news. Where is the joy? خلاص, it's gone. يعني بعد شهر لو واحد ما خبر وحش, الفرح كله بيطير من عنده. مهما كان فرحان وهيزق من نطت من دقيقتين. فرح العالم مش ثابت وبيروح ويجي ومعتمد على الظروف. يعني أنا فرحان if things are going well or if, لكن أنا مش فرحان لو الأمور باظت. وبعد شهر يعني لو راحت فضل رابط يعني فرحه بالعالم there are times that it gets so dark والإنسان يبقى ما عندوش فرح خالص. Now people in the world try to acquire this joy of the world through different ways. لكن أوريكم مثلا يعني مثلا الإنجيل يقول إيه؟ Saint Paul says, "Do not be drunk with wine, in which is dissipation, but be filled with the Spirit." إيه علاقة wine and the Spirit؟ الناس بتشرب يعني why do people get drunk? Because they want to be happy, so the wine makes them happy. But Saint Paul بيقول إن this is يعني this is not real joy. This is كده حاجة temporary, and when they wake up from it, they are even more distressed and more depressed than before. بيقولهم I have another solution for you. Be filled with the Spirit. هو ده الجوي اللي بقى if you get filled with it instead of be يعني getting filled with wine you will be joyful forever. And like Christ said يعني no one can take away your joy from you. لا ينزع أحد فرحكم منكم. احنا محتاجين الجوي ده في in the world we live in في العالم اللي احنا عايشينه محتاجين جدا الفرح اللي من فوق ده. يعني العالم اللي كمان الأيام دي بالذات وضع في الشرير زي ما الإنجيل يقول and it's very easy in, if we follow مثلا the news if you follow what happens the tragedies in the world حتى الإنسان يحس إن هو he's suffocating because of the absence of joy in his life. يحس إن هو his life doesn't have a taste كده لأن he's not feeling the joy. A solution. The solution is to be filled with the Spirit. And شوف when you get filled with the Spirit it does not change the situation. It does not necessarily resolve the problems or stop the tragedies but it gives you زي ما الفاذر calls it كده wings to fly above يعني circumstances. And تلاقي الإنسان كده living and there is something يعني there is a flame كده in the heart of joy that is not easily quenched. طبعا سان انتوني teaches that Satan tries to quench this flame يعني with all kinds of ways because he knows that as long as this flame is in our hearts he can do nothing to us. يعني الشيطان عايز يعكنن علينا. لو في شعلة الفرح دي في القلب بتاعت الروح القدس الشيطان عارف انه ما يقدرش يعمل حاجة خالص. فيقوم الشيطان يعني لما توني يتعلم ان الشيطان يعني يكثف حربه جدا على انه يطفي الشعلة دي في قلبنا. فاحنا لازم نكون واعيين للموضوع ده. المهم في آية تانية جميلة قالها سان بول تسالونيان بيقول لهم ايه؟ Having received the word in much affliction with joy of the spirit. يعني بالعربي بيقول لهم إذ قبلتم الكلمة اللي هي يعني the word of يعني the gospel طبعا. إذ قبلتم الكلمة في ضيق بسير بفرح الروح القدس. هنا في contradiction دلوقتي منين there is great affliction ومنين في joy of the spirit. هنا يوريك بقى إن يعني إن الروح فرح الروح ده independent of the circumstances of what's going on in your life. نسمع عن سان بول هو في السجن في wrote the epistle بتاعت فيليبي والرسالة كلها افرحوا في الرب be joyful in the Lord. We call it the epistle of joy Philippians. وهو كان بيكتبها هو في السجن وظروفه صعبة. الروح يدي كده ارتفاع كده حاجة يخلي الإنسان أعلى من كل الظروف. ف يعني أنا يعني we were reading a book كده this week with the servant and يعني one sentence struck يعني out كده when he says San Seraphim of Sarov which is يعني very known well known monk Russian monk that wrote about the Holy Spirit and he did not يعني bring those ideas from himself. طبعا this is the tradition of the deserts of Egypt when they teach about the importance of acquiring the spirit. المهم بيقول ايه؟ بيقول for the Holy Spirit turns to joy whatever he touches. لأن الروح القدس يحول كل ما يلمسه إلى فرح. الروح القدس يحول كل ما يلمسه إلى فرح. Sorry يعني I'm gonna give a bad example here maybe to understand يعني to understand يعني شوية disgusting example. If مثلا one of us get sorry I was touched by an insect or a snake بعد الشر touch not حتى يعني مش القرص ولا حاجة just touch what would you be your reaction؟ تلاقي الواحد على طول يعني very disgusted ويبقى يعني يعني يقرف قوي ويتشنج كده وبتاع. This is our feeling because we got touched by something not nice. The exact opposite is when the Spirit, Holy Spirit touches us. We get filled with كده a beautiful heavenly feeling. يعني whoever experienced the joy of the Spirit, if any one of us, طبعا hopefully all of us, have experienced, مثلا in one time he was praying and the Spirit touched him. And the joy he felt is otherworldly. مش من فرح مش من العالم ده. يحس ان هو عامل زي ما الانجيل يقول about the man who found the treasure. And out of joy he went and sold all what he has and came to buy to acquire this يعني this field or the precious stone. يعني يعني قالك من فرحه مضى وباع كل ما له هو اشترى هذا الحق. So whoever experienced the effects of, and the joy of the Holy Spirit, he feels that I'm ready to give everything just to acquire that in my life. حاجة من العالم تاني فرح من السماء بيسموه سبق تذوق a pre-tasting of the joy of heaven. كلنا بنسأل هو احنا هنعمل ايه في السماء what are we gonna do in heaven. When you get touched by the Holy Spirit in prayer, in one time you, يعني we obeyed the commandment, then you know the answer. Then you know, مش هنعمل ايه, you know what are we going to be feeling like in heaven. كده طبعا يعني طبعا on the tip of our tongues يعني على طرف لساننا كده بس بتدي الاختبار الجميل ده. فالروح القدس يحول الى فرح كل ما يلمسه. حاجة كمان جميلة قالها سان أنتوني on the Holy Spirit is that he says that the joy of the Spirit for the soul is like the water sorry, like the water needed to for the trees to grow. بيقول إن يعني إن الروح القدس هو الفرح بتاع الروح القدس sorry الفرح بالذات the joy بالذات عامل زي المية اللازمة لنمو الأشجار، اللي من غيرها الشجر ما doesn't grow. الفرح في الحياة الروحية عامل زي كده، الفرح هو اللي عامل زي البنزين like the fuel that pushes us forward no matter what يعني يعني happens to us in our lives. يعني هقول very short يعني story at the end مرة سمعتها من أبونا لوقا، أبونا لوقا سيدروس كان بيقول إيه يعني، هي بيقول إن هما he knew a right يعني a pious man كده from church إنسان روحاني وحلو and he was يعني serving with him in the church وبتاع، وبعدين أبونا لوقا سافر for years but didn't hear about him and then one time he heard that this man is in great affliction وكان يعني in deep distress يعني to the degree that he lost his peace and he يعني closed his doors on himself and people were يعني worried about him that he might even end his life يعني كانوا خايفين ان الراجل يعني يموت نفسه ولا حاجه لانه خلاص وصل لدرجه من اليأس يعني really يعني dark. فبيقول I felt really bad that يعني a righteous man like that and يعني get into this dark place so he called him on the phone and the man used to love Abuna Lua so much but when he picked up the phone and heard Abuna's voice he was so cold وقال له أيوة نعم what do you want فأبونا قال له we have hope in Christ وبتاع قال له tell me what do you want me to do قال له okay I'm gonna tell you one thing to do and promise me to do and then after that you could do whatever قال له أبونا قال له sit down and take a paper and a pen and start to write down all the good things all the things that the Lord has done unto you since you were born and all the dealings of the Lord with you كل اكتب قال له اكتب على ورقة كل اللي عمله معاك ربنا من يوم ما اتولدت كل تعاملات الله معاك وترتيبات الحياة. So the man said okay and he hung up and then few days later أبونا لقى يعني a phone call from this guy and when he picked up it was not the same guy it was like the old guy بقى تاني and his voice was so excited and told him أبونا how are you أبونا is like what happened he said the prescription worked قال له العلاج نفع قال له when I sat down to يعني write the Holy Spirit started to remind me هو Christ قال كده the Spirit was going to remind you started to remind me of things that were not خالص in my mind and I started to get amazed إن ربنا loves me that much and I didn't realize it and then I started to when he started to accept that he started to feel joy replacing this depression that he had ف بيقول ايه بيقول ان المشكله ما اتحلتش يعني المشاكل اللي عنده are the same بس اخذ ايه اخذ جناحات جناحات الروح القدس دي اللي هي الفرح جناحات الفرح جناحات الفرح اللي تخليه رغم ان المشكله لسه موجوده انما هو بقى اعلى منها it does not crush him ما بقتش ضغطاه بقى هو عالي كده وحاسس ان هو طاير وان ربنا بيحبه جدا وده عنده كفايه فربنا يدينا يعني ثمرة الفرح دي احنا محتاجينها جدا في هذه الايام ومحتاجين نقف نطلب الروح القدس ونطلب ثمار الروح القدس وفرح والمحبة والسلام وكل الثمار الجميلة يعني ربنا المجد دائما ابدا امين. Questions or comments?
Thank you, Michael.
طيب ابونا هنا ولا مش موجود؟ طيب نقول ابانا الذي Lord, hear us when we pray and thank thee, our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. In Christ Jesus our Lord, for thine is the kingdom and power and glory forever. Amen.